Welcome to Kakatiya Graduate Junior College online classes. So, dear children, today we are going to discuss about civics first year syllabus. Actually, already we completed 10 plus, so we promoted to the intermediate. So, I congratulate you to select CEC group. So, already in the previous classes, you studied about social studies. So it has divided into four parts: geography, history, civics and economics. So in the first year CEC group, civics is also one of our subject. So already you studied about geography, history, civics, economics. So what is meant by the civics? So what we studied in the first year. So in the first year we have 12 chapters. Our first year syllabus is divided into 12 chapters. They are Introduction of Political Science, second one is State and Sovereignty, third one is Nation, Nationality, and Nationalism. The fourth one is political concepts. Political concepts. And the fifth one is political ideologies. Political ideologies. And the sixth one is rights and duties. Seventh one is citizenship. And eighth one is democracy. Ninth one is secularism. Tenth one is constitution. 11th one is organs of government. 12th one is forms of the government. So these are the 12 concepts, 12 chapters in the first year civics. So introduction of political science. Second one is state and sovereignty. Third one is nation, nationality and nationalism. And fourth one is political concepts. And the fifth one is political ideologies. And the sixth one, states, sorry, rights and duties. And the seventh one is citizenship. And eighth one is democracy. Ninth one is secularism. Tenth one is constitution. 11th one is organs of the government, and the final one is forms of the government. So if we are going to discuss or study about all these 12 chapters in brief, introduction of political science. So in this chapter, first we have to know about the what is mean by the civics. So the civics word is derived from the polis, which is belonging to the Greek, and it means is city states. So origin of the civics and definitions of the civics and nature of the political science are and scope and significance of the vulgar signs. And at the same time, in this chapter, we discuss and we learn the relation between the political science and other social sciences like sociology, history, and economics. So this is the first chapter, introduction of political science. The second one is state and sovereignty. So in this chapter, what is meant by the state, the origin of the state, and elements of the states means people and territory, and like that we will learn about the elements of the state because it has five elements. Now next one is sovereignty. So how many kinds of sovereignty has? So what is mean by the sovereignty? So how a state gets its sovereignty, like that we will learn in the second chapter, state and the sovereignty. Third one is nation, nationality and nationalism. What is mean by the nation? What is a nationality? What is mean by the nationalism? So how a nation is forming and what kind of nations are there, like that we will learn in the third chapter, nation, nationality and nationalism. Now the fourth concept is political concepts. Under this chapter we learn about law, equality, liberty, power and authority. So all these we learn what is mean by law, what is equality, what is liberty, what is mean by power, what is mean by authority. So all these concepts we studied in the fourth concept, political concepts, chapter 4. In the chapter 5th, political ideologies. Political ideologies means what? Individualism, socialism, liberalism, Marxism and Gandhiism, like that different theories we will study in the political ideologies. Individualism means what? Socialism means what? Liberalism means what? Marxism means what? And the final is Gandhiism means what? We will study in the political ideology under the 5th chapter. And the 6th one is rights and duties. So how many kinds of rights are there? What is mean by the rights? Definition of rights. And what is mean by the duties? Relation between the rights and duties. We will study in the 6th chapter, rights and duties. Now 7th one is citizenship. So we are all living in different countries, so we have citizenship. When we have the citizenship, we are getting some benefits from the state and the nation. So what is mean by the citizenship? So how we acquiring the citizenship, how many kinds of citizens are there, and how we lose our citizenship, like that all these points are we will discuss in the citizenship chapter 7th one. And the democracy, already we heard and studied in our previous classes about the democracy. What is mean by the democracy? What kinds of democracy are there? How could we continue a democratic system in a country? So benefits and merits and demerits. So all these points we will learn in the democracy chapter. So 9th one is secularism. What is mean by the secularism? So in our constitution we introduced this one. Secular word means a country or state which doesn't support to any kind of religion, that means secularism. So what is mean by the secularism? What is a secular country? Like that points we will learn in the 9th concept, secularism. And 10th one is constitution. Constitution means, constitution is a book which says about rules and regulations, how we live in a country or how a government can function in a country. So all these are principles and we written in a book, that is called constitution. So what is meant by constitution? How many types of constitutions are there? So how a country continues his aims and objectives with the help of constitution. So we will learn all these points in the constitution. And 11th one is organs of the governments. So government has three organs: legislature, executive and judiciary. So these are the major organs of the government. So what is mean by the legislature? What is mean by executive? What is mean by judiciary? How all these organs functions there, and how all these organs done their duties in a country? So unicameralism, bicameralism. So which is benefits means merits and demerits. So executive merits and demerits, and judiciary merits and demerits. We will learn all these points in the organs of the government. And the final one is forms of the government. It means what? So organs of the government means legislature, executive and judiciary. So what is meant by legislature, what is meant by executive, what is meant by the judiciary? So bicameralism, executive functions and judiciary functions and judicial review, we will discuss in this chapter organs of the government. And the final one is forms of the government. So how many kinds of governments are there? Actually the governments are four kinds. So unitary government, presidentialship of government, parliamentary type of government. So federal government. So these are the four types of the governments. So relationship between the two types of government, parliamentary and presidentialship of government, unitary and federal government. What are the benefits and merits and demerits of the unitary government? What are the merits and demerits of federal government? What are the merits and demerits of parliamentary government? What are the benefits and demerits of the presidentialship of government? So these four kinds of governments comes under the forms of the government. So these are the 12 chapters we have in the first year civics. So introduction of political science, state and sovereignty, national, nationality, nationalism, political concepts, law, equality, liberty and justice, and power and authority, political ideologies, individualism, socialism, liberalism, Marxism, Gandhiism, rights and duties, citizenship, democracy, secularism, constitution, organs of the government, and final one is forms of the government.